Meghan and Harry plan to rent a second home in New York for private life. Meghan and Prince Harry are considering renting a second home in New York, it has been claimed. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex, who quit royal duties for a new life in the US in 2020, currently live in a mansion in California. But the couple are reportedly considering a second home in the Big Apple. Harry and Meghan are looking at renting a flat near the United Nations headquarters in Manhattan. The Sussexes visited the UN during a tour of New York last September, where they had a meeting with Deputy Secretary General Amin Mohammed. Ms. Mohammed tweeted afterwards, in conversation with the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, sharing how to engage on issues we care about deeply, climate action, women's economic empowerment, mental well-being, youth engagement and vaccine equity. The New York tour was the couple's first public appearance together since the birth of their daughter Lily in June. It was also Harry and Meghan's first major public trip post-Megxit. At one point, the Duchess was asked if she was enjoying her visit to New York. Meghan smiled and replied, "It's wonderful to be back, thank you." The Sussexes' New York tour also included an appearance at the city's One World Trade Center, built on the site of the Twin Towers which were destroyed in the 11th of September attacks. They posed for the media at the top of the skyscraper against the panoramic backdrop, alongside New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio and Governor of New York State Kathy Hochul. Meghan and Harry went on to meet youngsters from the Harlem School to promote literacy, where the Duchess read her children's book The Bench. The tour finished with the Sussexes stepping out on stage in Central Park for Global Citizen Live. The couple joined the 24-hour broadcast being staged in New York's famous Central Park and around the world. It was part of a number of shows being held in cities from London to Lagos, by the organization Global Citizen, urging leaders to adopt a vaccine equity policy to help end the pandemic. Harry and Meghan currently live in Montecito with their two children Archie and Lily. The couple quit as working royals in 2020 for a new life of personal and financial freedom in America. Representatives for the Sussexes have been contacted for comment. Meghan has shared an emotional statement where she revealed she and the animal rescue charity Mayhew would be opening a new wing and dedication of her late friend, Ollie Joost. Although the Duchess of Sussex stopped being a patron of the charity at the start of 2022, they have still joined forces for the moving moment. In the statement, Meghan recounted how her friend, who was an animal behaviorist, had introduced her to the charity and helped look after her dog, Guy, after he fell ill when she first came to the United Kingdom. "It was nearly 4 years ago, as I was exploring possible organizations to volunteer with, that Ollie brought me to Mayhew," she explained. She went on to say how Ollie had chosen the charity for her, knowing that she would be drawn to their deep love of community. Meghan sadly revealed that Ollie suddenly passed away on the 15th of January 2022. And as a result, she and Mayhew would be opening the Ollie Joost wing at the charity, which will help shelter animals that are struggling to find a new forever home. "Because much like Ollie, they will never be forgotten, and they will always be loved," she concluded. The statement also revealed that the Duchess was no longer involved with the charity as a patron, but that it still enjoyed her unwavering support. The charity also confirmed this in a small message that read, "Our royal patronage with the Duchess of Sussex came to an end at the beginning of the year. It's been an incredible privilege for Mayhew to have worked closely with Meghan, the Duchess of Sussex, since 2019 when she became our patron. Although Meghan and her husband, Prince Harry, were unable to attend the Duke of Edinburgh's service of Thanksgiving, Meghan did send a special gift to the event. The Duchess sent an eye-catching, colorful wreath that stood out amongst the stunning white wreaths from the royal family, which were pictured lying against the pews inside St. George's Chapel. The wreath, which was accompanied by a handwritten note from the Duchess, was made up of a variety of bright purple and blue locally sourced flowers, each of which had been thoughtfully selected, created by one of their favorite florists, Willow Crossley, and the royal couple specifically asked for the wreath to include Acanthus mollis, the national flower of Greece to represent Prince Philip's heritage, and Eryngium to represent the Royal Marines. Thank you for watching. If you like our video, would you please help us like, share and subscribe our channel? Wish you happy to see our videos, thank you very much.